Hello all, my name is Sandhya Kiran. I am working as Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department, St. Martin's Engineering College. Today we are going to see one of the core subjects of Civil Engineering, and that is Fluid Mechanics and Hydraulic Machinery. So, it's a part of Water Resources Engineering, and as a part of design of dams, reservoirs and other irrigational structures, civil engineer necessarily has to have an idea of hydraulic machinery as well, because the same goes into construction of a hydroelectric power plant. So the hydraulic machinery which is referred is are called as turbines and pumps. A turbine is a device which is used in a hydroelectric power plant to generate electricity because of the available head near a river or a dam. And whereas when you come across another hydraulic device called pump, it is necessarily comes into usage where we have to lift water from low-lying area to a high areas. So a device called pump necessarily it lifts the water from a low-lying area or any other fluid from a low-lying area to the high area. So the classification, if we see the hydraulic machinery, if we see turbines, there are three different turbines: the Pelton turbine, Kaplan turbine and the Francis turbine, and this is based on the available head near the river. The head of the river is considered as the height of the water in the river, which will be deciding the choice of the turbine that can be made in the hydroelectric power plant. Similarly, there are two types of pumps which are also hydraulic machinery. One is reciprocating pump and another one is centrifugal pump. Both are having the same function of lifting the water, whereas the working principles behind the machinery is different. If you take a reciprocating pump, a reciprocating pump works on the principle that it sucks all the air in the suction tube and creates a vacuum pressure, therefore which is the vacuum pressure inside the suction pipe is lesser than the atmospheric pressure that is existing outside, and this vacuum pressure is created in the reciprocating pump because of a arrangement called piston which moves to and fro continuously, and it creates a vacuum in the suction pipe, and this vacuum has negative pressure, that means it has any pressure which is lesser than the atmospheric pressure outside, and hence the mechanism of pulling the water into the suction pipe takes place, and from there on it is delivered into the exit pipe where it is to be lifted to the heights that the water is necessarily it has to be sent to. Whereas when we come across centrifugal pump, a centrifugal pump has different component which is like an impeller. An impeller is a object which is centrally located in a centrifugal pump, and there is a suction pipe which is dropped into the water or the low lying area. This suction pipe lies in the water level or the liquid level which is present in the low lying area, and this suction pipe has got a vacuum which is generated in the suction pipe because of the working principle of the centrifugal pump. And the working principle says that whenever the impeller, which is a circular object which rotates, there is a centrifugal action that takes place, and centrifugal action creates vacuum inside the suction pipe, and the water enters into the suction pipe because of the centrifugal action, and it is sent to the greater heights because of the pressure that is there in the delivery pipe. So the casing is also a component which is present in the low-lying water, where this is the casing of the pipe which helps the suction to happen in the suction pipe, and the impeller, because of its centrifugal action, it creates the negative or the vacuum pressure in the suction pipe, and it pulls the water into the suction pipe. suction pipe. So these are the components of a centrifugal pump. So what does a centrifugal pump do? It pulls huge amounts of liquids. It can be of various viscosities, say 680 Fahrenheit to 700 Fahrenheit of liquid is pulled using such centrifugal pumps. And the principle behind the working of the centrifugal pumps is that the flow of forced vortex, which develops the exterior torque, and it rotates the fluid and sends to the delivery pipe. So in this centrifugal pumps, we have the types like single stage centrifugal pump and two stage centrifugal pump and the multi stage centrifugal pump. The single stage centrifugal pump is very simple and it generates huge flow rates, but it is suitable only in the areas where the available height of water is low head, is necessarily a low head. Whereas a two-stage two-stage centrifugal pump comes with two impellers and it is suitable wherever there is a middle head, that is middle height of water available. There you can use the two-stage centrifugal pump. And the multi-stage centrifugal pump, we have multiple number of impellers located in the centrifugal pump, and it can be used where the height of water is necessarily very high. What are the advantages of centrifugal pump is that it very easily pumps out all the risky fluids, and there is no heat transfer because there is a motor which works separately and there is a pump which is working separately, and therefore there is low friction also. These are the key advantages of centrifugal pump. When we focus on to the disadvantages, there is lot of energy loss that is happening here, and also the fluid whenever the fluid is lesser in the pump, then the overheating of the pump happens and it can collapse or stop the working of the pump. So this is about the hydraulic machinery, a brief note, and we have focused on the pumps, especially the two types of pumps, the reciprocating and the centrifugal pump. We have said that the principle behind reciprocating work is generally because of the piston, which is a horizontal rod which moves to and fro, creating vacuum in the suction pipe, and this vacuum is having a negative pressure which is lesser than the atmospheric pressure existing outside. That's why it pulls the liquid into the suction pipe and pushes into the exit pipe. And the working principle between centrifugal pipe or pump is due to the impeller, and the impeller works on the forced vortex flow, and because of the centrifugal action it is giving, because of rotation, there is a negative pressure created in the suction pipe, and there is an exterior torque that is developed, and the vacuum that is generated in the suction pipe pulls the liquid into the pipe, and it transfers the water into the heights that is necessarily needed. So this is about the centrifugal pump and the reciprocating pump. Thank you.